Hey FTD fam, what's happening? Welcome back to another video. Good to see you guys again here in 2022. Just came back from a 2-week break, so guys, look out for more videos, more reactions, more thoughts about religion and spirituality. As well, I'll be answering a lot more of your questions coming up, so yeah, really good to be back. So either way guys, a video that I saw that really grabbed my attention, well, I didn't fully see it yet, I just saw the title. It's Before You Die, These Signs Will Happen. Yeah, kinda creeped out to watch this. Either way, let's go.
But before that day comes, there are signs.
What kind of signs?
Quite unusual that some people, they say, I didn't have a sign before I died. Everyone has a sign before they die.
Really?
Everyone.
Everyone?
But these signs are different. They come in various forms. Some people have immediate signs of death before they die, such as illness, such as even spiritual feelings. Others, they don't have any of these signs. It just hits them like that. But the signs I'm talking about is time. Time. As time progresses, as you grow in age, you're actually getting smaller in age. And therefore, time is one of the signs. Age is another. White hair is another. And the Prophet ﷺ said, everything has a cure, except for two things. Al-maut wal-haram, death and age, old age. There's no cure for old age. This world ending shows us that when Allah says that everything's going to die, it means everything in this world, including the world itself. Allah says in the Quran, everything on it will perish. The only thing that will be left, presence of your Lord. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in several verses that the world and the sky will perish. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say, "Ad-dunya faniya," the world is going to perish. A man asked him again, when is the last hour? He said, don't ask about that. What have you prepared for it? But the point is, they're asking because the Prophet had told them sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the world's going to end.
Going to end.
Allah says, the earth, the world, and the sky will be changed. From the world and the sky you knew once, to another world and sky. Meaning Allah's going to destroy it and recreate another, different to it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He replies to those who deny the end and resurrection. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, look at the way we created the life as an example of why, how we are going to resurrect you. Look at how He sends winds and clouds as a good sign for you. When the clouds fill up, we take it to a land that is dead, nothing, it's dry, drought. And from it, we bring back life of fruits. كذلك, just like that, Allah says, كذلك, just like that, or similar to that, we will raise the dead people. And Allah says, كَلَّا سَتُبْعَثُنَّ, behold, you shall be resurrected. The signs are many. There are minor signs and major signs. As for the minor signs, they began the minor signs of the closeness of the world's end, the death of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Naam, his death. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, the day of accountability has come very close to the people, while the people are in an illusion of their own, ghafla, they're forgetful of it, they're too busied away from it. Yal'aboon, they're playing around. Allah says, do you not consider that when the day comes, it may come to you while you are playing, or while you are just in ghafla, forgetfulness, or unaware? So when the world ends, brothers and sisters, it'll be a time where the majority of the people of the world are going to be in losthood, forgetfulness, ghafla, meaning unaware, too busy with imaginations and illusions and things, ideas they've made up. And Allah says in the Quran about these types of people to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when the Prophet tried to call them and teach them, and he would tell them, please listen to me, I want to save you. And a lot of them wouldn't listen. Allah said to him, let them eat and let them entertain themselves and let them play and let false hope delude them. And he let their hopes, let it delude them. Let it take over their minds for a little temporary while. فَسَوْفَ يَعْلَمُونَ. At the end of it, they're soon going to come to know the reality. It's going to face them. It's going to grab them. It's going to face them right in the face. And they can't run away from it.
For sure, it's a reality that we are all are going to face death. You know, it's something that's so sure, and some of us don't like to talk about it. Some of us talk about it more than others. And it's kind of interesting though, because one of the movies, the last movies that I saw over the break that just passed was Don't Look Up, about the end of the world, this meteor coming. And it's interesting that the first video literally that I see when I'm back is a video talking about the end of the world. But let's just backtrack a little bit. At the beginning of the video, it talked about some signs that will pop up before you die. So, okay, yeah, I get that. You know, there's certain signs like illnesses, right? There's some family members that I have, like my grandmother I was very close with. We could see that, okay, she was coming near to the end of her life because, you know, she was in the hospital a lot more frequently. So, of course, inevitably, she passed away of various health conditions, right? And the sign of gray hair, the sign of aging, for sure. Yeah, that's all biological and everything. But he did mention that there are signs, spiritual feelings. Now, I'm not exactly sure what that means, but I have heard people say that before they've died, or they've told other people, and the other person now who's alive is saying it. They said that this person, before they died, they were saying things like, they have like this strange feeling, or like they have these dreams that, you know, they were dying in their sleep, and, you know, all these type of things. I assume that that's what he meant, but really there wasn't any clarification on that. So a spiritual feeling, really, what does that actually mean? I've heard other cases of people saying that they have had visions of the future, or people showing up and telling them that, hey, you know, get your life straight, get your life, you know, just random things like that. So maybe spiritual, supernatural occurrences as well. Really hoped that this video is gonna dive more into that, but it was more so, I guess, just a look that when you're gonna die, there are certain things that you can look at and say, okay, well, your life is coming to an end. But one of the things, though, is the end of the world completely, where all life is gone. Now, whether you believe in that or not, it's still a prevalent belief in Islam. And what I'm finding out is that a lot of the teachings of Islam is to prepare somebody not just for the time of death, but also if that person or people are alive at the end of time, to prepare them for that. Because inevitably, whether you die before the end of time or not, you're gonna die. So what's gonna happen after that? And Islam really attempts to explain what happens after death. And I'm starting to see more and more of why Muslims are so passionate about sharing their faith, because if they believe that they have the answer for what happens after death, then yeah, you're gonna really want to tell people about that. But I guess now the question always just comes down to you as an individual. Like, what are you doing with your life? How are you preparing? What are you doing? What are your thoughts like? What habits are you developing? Because yeah, you just look around and death is inevitable. But yeah, that's my two cents on this, guys. Thanks for hanging out with me in another episode. Feels so good to be back. Good seeing you guys and hanging out with you. And yeah, stick around for new videos coming up. If you haven't done so already, don't forget to leave a like before you head on out. And I'll catch you in the next one. Later.